Welcome to Superior Profit Weekly Market Roundup, 8th April 2017. I am Sagar Nandi, Chief Analyst and Trader of Superior Profit, based in Singapore. I will not take time to introduce myself. If you would like to know more about me, about the company, Superior Profit, and more importantly, about how you can use Superior Profit way to invest profitably, you may visit the About page and learn more about that from our homepage. Before we begin, let us go through the standard disclaimer. This demonstration is for educational purposes only. It is designed to share information on Superior Profit's trading system. The information presented here should be used only by people who are aware of the risk inherent in trading. Past performance is no guarantee of future return. Superior Profit is not an investment advisor. This session is not for any recommendation of buying or selling stock or any other instrument. Superior Profit will have no liability for any investment decisions made by its audience. As usual, we will look at key technical analysis of key markets, oil, gold, India Nifty, and some Forex index, Forex symbols. Then we will go to US market and look at the three broad market ETFs before going into broad market sector and industry analysis and ranking. We will look at some of the trade ideas shared earlier. And if you have any idea for the upcoming week, we'll be going through that. Q&A is throughout the session. You may use the Q&A panel to ask questions. I will keep an eye on it on my second monitor and try to answer them as I go along. If I cannot answer any question during the session, I'll make sure before I end, I answer all the questions. That was the last presentation slide for today. Let us begin with the topics that we need to cover. Let us start with oil. Here we are looking at oil ETF USO with weekly backdrop template on the left hand side and daily hop on template on the right hand side. As we had discussed last week, the market roundup, two weeks ago actually, we had a potential long opportunity on this day. The candle before that was a Friday, and we concluded that if next day, that is this day, price went above early range high, then we could take a long trade. That could be a day trade. It could also be a precision entry swing trade. And that trade was posted in the community. USO bounce long trade discussed in the weekly market roundup. That trade worked out pretty well. If you have not gone through the USO trade that was shared at that time, you may go through the weekly market roundup recording as well as the trade that was shared in the community at that time. If we look at the last few days, then oil had gone up more, ostensibly because of increased stress in Middle East. But we see that if we are following Superior Profit Q trading system, then we are in the trade much ahead of others. By the time the news of Syria conflict escalation came up somewhere here, we have already entered the trade long time ago and made significant profit. Those who use technical analysis see this pattern playing out over and over again. That is, by the time people think because of certain news like Middle East conflict, in this case oil price is going up, at least that is what the media makes us believe, the people who are using robust technical analysis are already probably booking profit because they entered the trade long time ago. They didn't rely on certain apparent market moving news to come out. That is the advantage of technical analysis using a robust system like Q trading system. Of course, we also like to keep an eye on the news. How far finally we trust our eyes and thereby profit more than other traders. At the right edge of the chart, there is no entry opportunity right now. It is already above upper boundary. It is too extended on the upside, as can be seen from the stretch release, bullish stretch, the green dots on top of the candles. So in superior profit way, we will not like to take a long position at this point. We would have taken the long position already long time ago. At the same time, we are not going to short also at the top because there is no bearish signal. There is neither any bear release nor any headwind signal, and also the candle traffic light color is green, that is bullish. Once price goes to the memory resistance line, we may expect it to tilt down. We can see that that is the same level where US oil also will hit the very slow white direction line. So there is a possibility price will tilt down from there, giving us a very low risk bounce trade entry opportunity. So we may keep an eye on that. Those who entered long earlier at this point, they must have booked some profit in superior profit way along the way. For the rest of the position, one may continue to hold and let profit run. We may use the hop-off template and the queue protection signal to put stop loss. So right now our stop loss might be here, and then if US oil continues to go up, the protection signal will also continue to go up and we can keep moving trailing stop upward. The magenta dots are used as trailing stop for long position, and when an instrument goes down, the cyan dot is used as trailing stop for short position. That was about oil. Let's look at gold. We look at the GLD ETF. The time when we suggested taking a long position in oil, at that time we saw that gold was reversing down from memory resistance, and we had thought of taking a short trade. Again, that was shared in a weekly market roundup, and it was shared in the community trade ideas as well. If you have not looked at that trade, you may look through the community postings. This gold signal on 28 March, and then I had followed up later. Initially, we thought of taking a short when gold price was coming down from this memory resistance line. So using real-time chart, one could have entered the short on this day itself using Q fine-tuned 5-minute template, and significant profit as a day trader could be achieved on the same day. Some part of the position could be held on, and then as of this chart, when price hit the cyan direction line, I had put up this chart in the community saying that on 5th April, gold hit ascending standard direction line. Relative performance is still bearish, but superior profit trader would make sure that the trade does not turn from a profitable one to a losing one from now onward. I put this comment based on the observation that gold was hitting the ascending cyan direction line. This was an intraday chart, and this was a good call again, because later on that same day, this is the candle of the same day. Once the day closed, we see that gold strongly went up from the cyan direction line. So in superior profit way, any direction line that is ascending can act as a support. It can be the cyan direction line, the yellow or the white direction line. In this case, on this particular day, gold had opened with a gap down and then it hit exactly the cyan direction line. In real time fine tune chart, I saw that it was going up above RD range high, and that time I had shared the idea that one should not take risk and make sure that if any short position being held is exited with some profit. Now at the right edge of the chart, it again gave a trade opportunity because price went above the memory resistance line and also the watermark high level. So we always know that when price goes to a memory resistance or watermark resistance level, there is a chance that price can come down. There is a chance, and therefore we can use the fine-tuned real-time template to try to take a very low risk short trade on the intraday basis. So we decide our signal based on daily chart, memory resistance and watermark in this case, but actually entered the trade on real-time chart as a day trade. This would have been a very profitable trade again. Here on the left-hand side, we look at the same gold chart. This is Friday's candle, the last candle, where price went to this watermark level and went to the next watermark level as well, tried to go up, then tilted down in terms of daily candle, creating a fake upside breakout. And the memory resistance level was also there. So if we now look to the 5 minute chart of GLD, we see that price had opened with a big gap up. This green line is last day's high, Thursday's high. On Friday, price opened here, so there was a very sizable gap up. It tried to go up, but we were aware of the resistances present in the daily chart. So we were looking for a short trade, and a short trade could be entered using the bear release signals, any of them. The most useful was the red candle with the bear release, and that would be a very profitable trade. For a trade with bear release, which is a very fast signal, the stop is very narrow, just above the recent high. If we took any of the three bear release signals, stop was never hit, and instead price went down, one could start booking profit once the risk distance was covered and then hold on to the remaining position and exit it, probably at this green automatically drawn real-time pivot level. So in this way, we saw that few weeks ago, we could take a gold long trade based on memory support in daily. We could use the daily memory support to take a trade using real-time fine-tuned template. And now we see on Friday, we use the opposite end signals, that is the resistance memory, to take a short trade in gold. In both directions, we came up with significant profit relative to risk. This is the way we like to take day trades, or precisely enter swing trades, that is taking very low risk and achieving relatively much bigger profit. As I discussed in last class also, we don't like to just open the real-time chart, that's the fine-tuned template on the right-hand side, and start trading. We identify the trade using daily chart and take the trade using real-time chart, thereby aligning more and more edges to our trade's favor. If we look at gold on the right-hand side, in terms of swing trade, there is no valid trade signal Yet, almost all the requirements of bounce trade are being fulfilled on the right hand side, except that price didn't close below Thursday's close. So on Monday, if we see price continuing to go down, then one might take a low risk swing short trade on gold. But as of Friday's close, there is no standard swing trade setup. The day trade opportunity was there and that had exited with profit. Now there is another instrument that is closely related to gold, that is silver. And if we look at the silver ETF SLV, we saw a very similar pattern played out. Silver in weekly chart came to memory resistance line, two of them, tried to go up and came down, making a false upside breakout in weekly. And at the same time in daily chart, there was pre-existing memory line and watermark level. Price tried to go up and came down again, creating a false upside breakout in daily as well. On Friday, price came down with very high activity. And just like in case of gold, if one was keeping an eye on the memory resistance, one could take a very profitable intraday short trade using SLV. If we go to the fine-tuned template, we can check it out. This is the fine-tuned template of SLV as of Friday. We see that price opened with a gap up. Green level was Thursday's high. Friday price opened at the blue line. Then the early range was formed, early range low here and early range high. In this case, one could take the short trade on this bear release candle, which also went below early range low, that is giving us a short opportunity using early range breakout mechanism. Stop would be just above early range high that was never breached. Instead, price fell. Profit could be booked once the risk distance was covered, that is partial profit, which happened at the green pivot line, and one could continue to hold the remaining position as silver fell and probably close it at the end of the day. Again, keeping an eye on memory resistance watermark level on daily chart gave us a very profitable day trade opportunity or precision swing trade entry opportunity on real-time chart. Let's now look at some of the international markets and forex. Let's look at first Nifty. Nifty is the India broad market index and NIFC1 is the future on that. In last few classes, we had discussed that prices at very high level, our optimal long entry point was here, again using memory support and watermark support level. Since this price had gone up and at the right edge of the chart, somewhere here last week we discussed that we will like to look for a short opportunity. And on last Friday, the bearish headwind signal appeared. However, there is a memory support line very close to the closing price. So we will not be taking a short trade. However, those who had taken a long earlier, surely they would have booked some profit along the way and maybe holding some position still. They will be cautious to make sure that the profit is not eroded if price comes down. However, right now they have no reason to exit if they are still holding the long position taken long time ago. They can continue to hold the long position and set trailing stop using the queue protection signal that is available in the hop off template. If we look at the at a glance weekly and daily both for Nifty, then we will see that the weekly candle on the left hand side is also bearish. The shape of the candle is bearish with upper tail. So on daily chart, if the memory support was not there and if price was higher above upper boundary, somewhere here maybe, then we could think of taking a short trade if price was somewhere here above upper boundary and far away from the support memory. But now we will not take the trade, but we see that the weekly is also bearish in shape. Sometimes if you want to look at the memory lines more clearly, then you can apply the clean chart template. In the clean chart template, we only have the first signals, that is the watermark level, bull bear release, stretch signal, and the memory lines. These are extremely fast and it helps us decide on the bounce trade as well as the box trade. Bounce trade is one of the standard trades based on exhaustion. Box trade is one of the standard trades in sideways market. To decide these two trades, you may look at the clean chart template as is shown here. And if you are looking for a trend following trade, then you can use the hop on template. Of course, you can use the hop on for exhaustion based bounce and sideways box also. But if you want to see clear chart with less signals, then you can use this template. So you can see here more clearly that there is a memory support just below Friday's close. And we are always respectful of the memory support resistance and therefore we will not take a short trade at this point. Let's look at some Forex symbols. Let's start with Sing Dollar. Last week we discussed that price was at the horizontal white slow direction line and there was no trade signal to take either long or short. And as of Friday's close also, there is no valid trade signal. The traffic light candle color is green, that is bullish. However, in a stock or instrument that is going down, lower high, lower low, that is in downtrend, we rather look for this kind of magenta candle to take short and we ignore the green candles when a stock is in downtrend. So our next trade opportunity could come if price goes to one of these memory resistance lines and tilts down, giving us a bounce short opportunity. Or price may go to somewhere here and tilt down, giving us a magenta candle that will be a go with flow short opportunity on Sing Dollar. If you check the community, then you will see that we shared some trade ideas on Australia dollar and also euro. In the euro at a glance chart, few days ago, we saw a bearish headwind had appeared when price came to the very slow white direction line and the weekly candle was bearish in shape with upper tail. That was a valid headwind short signal and I had shared it in the community at that time. Let's see how euro played out since then. Here we see once again that the headwind signal worked very well. It was a very low risk short entry opportunity. One could start booking profit somewhere along this candle when the risk distance was already covered. Stop would have been just above recent high. So somewhere in this magenta candle or at the yellow slow direction line, partial profit could be booked and one could continue to hold the remaining position. On Friday, it hit the memory support line. That would be another partial profit booking area. One might continue to hold some position still and see if it can breach the memory support. However, in superior profit way, again, we are respectful of the memory support. Therefore, it is surely some profit booking area for a short position. So the trade idea that was shared based on the headwind short swing trade worked out very well. and euro continues to be bearish. On the right hand side, of course, we will not enter any trade right now. It is too late for us. We like to enter trade much before using the standard trade setups. In community, we also had shared a trade idea few weeks ago on Aussie dollar. That was a bounce box swing trade, also a short trade. At that time in the weekly chart, we saw that price had come to the memory resistance and it was possible that it could bounce down. And then in the weekly market roundup of that time, we had discussed that if price came to the daily memory resistance and tilted down, one could enter a short. Stop would be just above recent high, above the memory resistance, and one could start booking profit once the resistance was covered. That could be done starting from the magenta candle. Let's see how is Australian dollar today. Here our short trade, bounce and bounce trade using the memory line, box trade using the watermark level, short on this bear release signal, worked out very well. Partial profit could be taken on the magenta candle and some position could be held. And as Australian dollar fell more, the overall position has reached much more profit than the risk that was taken in this trade. That is the value of using the trades and sharing them in the community. We can look back and see how, if we are trading in a disciplined way, following the Q trade signals, quite a large percentage of times the trades work in our favor. And because we like to take a trade only if risk and reward are somewhat proportionate, reward is comparable to the risk, so overall we tend to get very high profit on an annualized basis, even without using forex, even using stock. And of course forex has more risk, but these are all swing trade examples. If one had traded forex using the Q charts as swing trade, we can see one could get very large profit in swing trading forex as well. Of course it could be traded as day trade also. Just as we saw in case of gold, when price came to memory line, we could anticipate a move down and take a short in gold. The exact same thing happened in Australia dollar. When price came to this memory line, we could anticipate price going down and we could day trade short at that time. Similarly, when the traffic light candle came on this day, it was a short opportunity. So next day, on an intraday basis, one could use fine-tune template to take short trades, day trade short. So either using swing trade or using day trade, one could trade profitably forex, just as one could profitably trade the commodities like gold, silver, oil, etc. Now let's look at the three US market ETFs. Let's look at SPY. Now, amid all the market noise about Syria conflict, etc., we see price really didn't move last week. It almost didn't move in terms of daily chart. Though media would like us to think otherwise, probably, for all the events happening like Chinese president visiting US or the conflict in Syria, market really didn't move. Last week, SPY had opened with a gap down but closed higher. And this week is a very narrow range, indecisive candle shape in weekly chart. And in daily also, we see there is hardly any movement. It is almost sideways movement. If we look at Dow Jones Industrial Average, again, weekly is very indecisive. People call this doji candle, open and close almost at the same level and with long upper tail and lower tail. And Delhi also hardly moved. It is also inside a triangle pattern, meaning there is no decisive direction in the broad market ETF. If we look at QQQ, which had been stronger of the three ETFs, again in daily chart last week hardly moved. In weekly chart, we see that it tried to go up but closed almost at the same level as last week's close. So the market didn't move at all in terms of all the three ETFs. Let's now look at broad market sector and industry analysis. I have already created the charts for that. You can also access them. For broad market analysis, you can go to home and broad market. For sector industry, you can go to home and sector industry page for ranking and heat map for sector industry. But let me go through that some chart and graph that I have already prepared. For broad market, we look at NASDAQ on the left and NYSE on the right, composite indices using weekly chart. We see that on NASDAQ composite, it didn't move at all, almost horizontal in terms of price move. And though NASDAQ composite is moving down compared to last week, price closed almost at the same level. The internals, as we are saying for a long time, continues to be weak. If we look at the individual values, we see all of them decline. Green means it declined, but still is above zero. So the new high low is still above zero for both NASDAQ and NYSE, but the other four internals, that is advanced decline and up down volume, not only declined, but they closed below zero. So we say in summary that the indices on weekly chart, which is useful for longer term investing, continues to be bullish, internals continue to be bearish, and specifically for last week, the readings are bearish as well. Finally, we make profit by trading the actual instrument, which may be ETF or stock, and that is still in uptrend for longer term weekly analysis of the composites. Now let's look at some sector and industry graphs. Every week we look at these graphs. In this graph showing sector performance across three review periods, last 5 days is the red bar, blue bar is 5 days prior to that, green bar is 10 days prior to blue bar. So together they constitute about 20 days or 1 month of price movement. We see that biggest switch is in utilities, which turned from worst ranker. It was worst ranker 10 rank last week, 10 out of 10 sectors, and now it became top ranker, rank 1 out of 10 sectors. That is a big switch from last week's negative value to this week's positive value. Most sectors turned positive. 1 week ago, most were negative. 2 weeks ago, most were positive. So this positive, negative, positive switch keeps on happening. We are calling this flip-flop. That is still happening this week, not as much as last week, but we can see that the composites ETFs are not moving, and the same information is available from this sector performance chart. Telecom continued to be poor ranker. Last week it was 9 and this week it has become 10. So telecom continues to be weak, but for the other sectors we see big flip-flop. If we go now to the industry analysis, the 5 best performing industries over last 5 days, the coal continues to perform very well. Last week also it was a strong performer. This week coal industry went up by 5.8%. So for several weeks, coal is going up, and in superior profit way, if the industry is going up, as we can see from these graphs and also from the industry ranking table, one could look for and actually take profitable swing or day long trades on coal companies. Now, renewable energy equipment had been a laggard for a long time, but after many weeks, it has come in the list of best performing industries. It went up by 2.4%. And later on, we'll look at the heat map that it is showing some sign of strength across last 5 days and 10 days. And one may look for bottom catching long opportunities in one of the stocks in this industry group. If we go to the worst performing industries for this week, there is not much pattern except that two of them are related to automobile. Auto parts declined most by 5.5%. And this industry group related to auto parts again dropped by 2.7%. So one may look for short opportunities in these two industries, or auto-related, auto parts-related industries. There is no other clear pattern in the rest of the declining worst-performing industry groups. We also look at the best rank improving and worst rank declining industry groups. And in sector analysis, we saw that utility had a big switch from worst ranking to top ranking, and that is evident in the industry group as well. Multiple utility related industries, multi-utility, conventional electricity, electricity, utility, gas and water, five of them came in the list of biggest rank improving industries. For the rest, there is some similarity between paper and forestry and paper, but if you are going through the weekly roundups every week, then you know that this industry is showing flip-flop along with many other industries. If we look at the biggest rank declines, there is not very clear pattern. We saw that telecom continues to be weak, and we see that mobile telecom is among the biggest rank declines as well. Now, if you are checking up the companies in mobile telecom, you may find that they are already quite low, maybe at pendulum low for some of the companies. So we have to finally look at the Q charts to decide whether to take a short or wait for these industries to tilt up, show improving rank, and go for a long-term long investment in these companies, or even a swing trade long in these companies. So in this way, we look at broad market sector and industry, and then finally at Q charts, and only take a trade when the sector industry analysis tells us to trade in the same direction as is told by the Q charts. Thereby we align more and more edges to our trade's favor, and that results in a higher level of consistency and profitability than using technical analysis alone. So we went through few commodities, oil, silver, gold. We looked through India market, Nifty futures, few forex pairs, US market ETFs, broad market sector, and industry analysis. Now we also create a ranking and heat map table of sector and industries every week and post it in our site. And as we mentioned, utilities became rank one in last 5 days period. In the last weekly review, we saw that utilities was number 10. So that was the big switch. Telecom continues to be weak. If we go down, we will look at the industry ranking and heat map table. we see that coal is continuing to be strong, starting from the period between last 2 months to last 1 month. So somewhere along this line, one could already look for long opportunities in coal stock. And now 1 month has passed, one would have surely booked some profit by now. And I mentioned about renewable energy. It was a laggard for long, long, long time, ranking 160, 159, 160, 159 over many review periods. But over last 10 days, it gained significantly from 160 to 69. And over the last 5 day period, it gained significantly again, improving from 69 to 6. Because this industry group was lagging for a long time, one may look for bottom catching opportunity in this industry group. Similarly, you may look for other industry groups that are turning from cyan to magenta in heat map, like toys, which was ranking very high, 644 for 3 review periods, then declined to 27, then to 99, now a big drop again to 144. So somewhere along this line, one is already looking for short opportunity, and you may still look for swing short opportunities or even top catching short opportunities in toys based on this ranking and heat map table. Let's now look at some of the trade ideas that were shared earlier. In last week's market roundup, we had discussed about few ETFs and we decided that XRT could have a short opportunity. I had followed up on that in the community. In the last weekly market roundup, I had discussed that there was a bear release signal. However, the candle color was green, so we were not going to short immediately. But if next day price was going below, using the fine-tuned chart, we could take a short trade. And that worked out well. As seen from the fine-tuned template, the early range high and early range low were formed on Monday. Price went below early range low, which would be a short entry point. Stop will be at early range high, that was never triggered. And once price went down and covered risk distance, we could start booking profit. Again, yet another example of how we can use daily chart to anticipate trades, and using fine-tuned real-time chart to either take a day trade or precisely enter a swing trade. Let's look if any new trade idea was shared. Let's look at BETR. Now, instead of going to the community, let me show this stock BETR using at a glance template. And I ask you a question now, looking at this at a glance, do you think there is a trade opportunity? If so, long or short, and what trade setup? You may answer using the Q&A panel. Yes, Terry says go with flow long. That's right. Now, today, let's also use Zenith to look at some more information on BETR. If we come back to before looking at the Zenith, if we come back to BETR at a glance template, then we confirm the view of Terry, and I think all of you who are following futures have the same view. In the weekly chart, after a sizable drop several weeks, and prior to several months ago, it had a big drop. Price was slightly going above, and this is the first week where backdrop candle color turned cyan after the earnings drop. This week earnings happened, 0.09 cent EPS, which is positive and which is also bigger than last quarter EPS. Last quarter was 2 cents. This quarter was 0.09, but price still dropped. After the drop in the earnings week, it started recovering and now it has turned cyan. We can see in daily chart that this is the earnings day. After that, price had a series of drop days and since then it stabilized. At the right edge of the chart, it has a very bullish shape candle. For this entire period, there was no such bullish shape candle. This is the first candle with bullish shape, and though activity was not very or extreme high, it was high. And this green high activity bar is higher than several days of move in few weeks in the when it was slides gradually starting to go up. So one could take a very low risk entry in this stock, putting stop just below recent low using hop-off template, probably booking partial profit once the yellow slow declining direction line is hit, which will be the same time when the memory resistance is hit. Of course, sometimes we see price piercing through and closing above. In that case, we don't need to exit the position in a hurry, but more often than it pierces through and closes high, we will see more often it will go and then probably move down little bit. That's why we are always aware of the declining memory resistance as well as the direction lines. Even booking profit at this level, partial profit at least, will give good reward risk ratio, and one could consider taking a long trade. It is also at pendulum low. That is, if we change to the pendulum template, we can see that it became severely low magenta and then gradually turning red. It is still at pendulum low. It's a very optimal point to take a long-term investment long position. That is superior profit way. For long-term investment, we don't like to take position in a stock which is already at high. We wait for a stock to come down, stabilize, and show long entry signal in hop on template while the price is still at or near pendulum low, as in this case. Now, if we notice the sector and industry, we see it is in consumer non-cyclical sector and food processing industry. In superior profit way, we always like to check that the trade is supported by sector industry or not. So let's go back to our sector industry ranking table. And we see that for consumer non-cyclical goods and services, it had a rank improvement from 9 to 6 for 5-10 days period to 5 days period. That is from last 10 days to last 5 days, it improved from 9 to 6. But sometimes 10 days and 5 days may be changing swiftly or flip-flopping. We may look for the monthly data for more certainty, more stable trend. And we see that earlier it was one of the worst performers, 9 out of 10, very poor ranker. And since then it has stabilized at middle of the rank, 4 to 5. So non-cyclical is not declining. On a monthly ranking basis, it is stable, and this particular company is at pendulum low, showing sign of going up. So let's look at its industry also. Industry was food processing. So if we find food products or food producers, we see that rank also improved from 121 to 61 between the last two review periods. Over longer term, it was more magenta before and not very decisively steady trend, but it is more cyan now than it was earlier. At least it is not against taking a long position in this industry group. So the sector and industry analysis is supporting taking a long trade in BETR. That is the way we like to use the sector industry ranking and align that with our Q technical chart analysis. Let's look at some more information on this company using Zenith. This is BETR. This is Amplify Snack Brands company. This is a snack company focused in developing and marketing products that appeal to consumer preferences better for you. So you can get what they produce. You may also look at their business information and see from which countries their revenue is coming from. You can see in terms of geographic segment, US revenue is 85% and only 15% of the revenue comes from international segments. So if you are bullish on the US economy on food and beverage consumption, which is my view because jobless claims are going down, employment is going high, people seem to be spending more than they were earlier, and this is non-cyclical company, food beverage. People are also becoming more aware on healthy foods. So it seemed to have many factors in its favor, including the US economy, and most of their sales come from US, so that is also in favor of this stock. If we go back to overview, we see that over last 1 year period, it has gone down by 41%, whereas SPX, that is SPY, the S&P 500, has gone up by 15%. So it has underperformed the market by 55-56%. However, at the right edge, we can see, of course, we saw in Q charts in more detail, it was showing that price was stabilizing. So again, these are the points where we would like to take a long-term position in a company which has fallen but showing sign of strength now. Sign of stabilization. Next earnings report is in May, so there is some period, about slightly less than 1 month, so it is fine to take a long-term position. Now if we look into more detail using Zenith, for charting we use Q charts, but this is just a simple chart which shows there were several gaps. These were probably associated with earnings. I think this is also associated with earnings. Now there is no conclusive evidence that if we follow analyst recommendation we make profit. Usually analysts upgrade or downgrade after quarterly results are known, or maybe several quarterly results are known. So by the time they increase estimate or decrease estimate, it is already too low. That is what I observe for most of the stocks. So for any stock that I am trading, I like to verify that observation, that is following analysts is not of much use for us. Superior profit traders, we can do better. And let's check that out for BETR again. So if you see this sharp drop in earnings projection, it happened on this candle exactly, actually after this candle. But by that time, price has already dropped significantly, very significantly. So if we are a Q trader, we are already out of the long position long time ago and taken a short because we can clearly see lower high, lower low. So we have already taken a short trade long before analysts actually revised their earnings estimate. Here again, we see that analysts reduce their estimate on this green bar, right? But by that time, price has already fallen a lot, quite a lot. So again, the more we see these charts, we come to the data-based conclusion, no subjective decision, but data-based conclusion that if we follow analyst estimate of earnings per share or revenue, we will always be lagging the price move. And if we use technical analysis using Q system, we'll be ahead, much ahead of other traders. Would you agree with this observation? If you are using Zenith, you can actually look up more and more stocks, be it this kind of company, be it ETR or be it Apple or Microsoft, more well-known companies. You will see the same thing playing out over and over again. Still, if for every stock that I trade, especially for long-term investment, I don't mind just opening this chart and revalidating the conclusion again that following analyst estimates is of not much use for us. We can do much better than that. Let's look at now some more useful information. Here we see that earnings dropped, then earnings went up. Revenue increased, it didn't drop actually. But can you see any link with the stock price? We can see, for example, this seems to be an important brief. Let's look at it. This is quarterly earnings. Now, this quarterly earnings data, we have to remember this quarterly earnings data is actually referring to which bars? It is actually referring to these two bars because the earnings is of the past period. This announcement is for this period. And we can see that relative to last quarter, earnings dropped, revenue went up, price dropped heavily. But we are already short long time ago again. And just before earnings, we are not going to take a position. We may take a position long time ago using the go with flow short signal that surely would have come around this point. We are already short, booked some profit. And if we have booked some profit just before earnings, there are multiple ways of trading. You could hold small position or you could sell all the positions and instead buy a put option using part of the profit. Therefore, even if stock went up after earnings, you will have profit in your hand. And if it goes down, you will have significant gain using the put position as would have been in this case. But I don't recommend holding the full position on a stock across the earnings, especially for a short position. Now, if we look at the right edge of the chart, this brief is also, I think it's earnings. Let's see. Yes, Q4 earnings. So, you know, this earnings is related to the previous period. So these are the revenue and earnings for that period. Now, if you compared to last quarter, one quarter ago, both earnings and revenue went up, but price actually came down. But we know based on data that earnings actually went up. Now, we don't want to trade against the market, so we are not going to take a long position when price is falling. In superior profit way, we don't try to catch a falling knife, but we saw that price is stabilizing. And now at the right edge, we have a bullish candle. We saw that more clearly in the Q charts. So this gives us some basis also from the fundamental side to take a long position. We already had some support from sector industry. Now we saw that earnings and revenue actually went up one quarter ago to the last quarter, though price dropped. Maybe it is to shake out the weak hands. We don't know conclusively, but we don't mind again taking a long position now with very low risk. That is, the stop loss is very small. Some more information that we can get from Zenith. Let me show. And this is exactly how I use Zenith actually. Now remember, I would like to repeat, for a swing trade, an average swing trade is held for about 5 days. So fundamental of a stock doesn't matter so much. We still like to align sector industry strength or weakness to our swing trade, strength for long position and weakness for short position. Those are also number based, but I don't like to look at fundamental for short term swing trade. But for BETR, it is also a potential low risk long term investment, and in those cases I go through more detail on Zenith. That is Thomson Reuters icon, but you can see all of these analyses are visual analysis. There is no number crunching, etc. info. So now I am going to look at quote history. It shows at which price level, how much transactions are happening. So these are the different price ranges, 9 to 10, 10 to 11, 11, 12, etc. For capturing the bottom of a stock, this is not mandatory, but I would like to see that when I'm catching the bottom of a stock, that is at pendulum low in Q charts, there is relatively very high transaction that has taken place, meaning big players are buying heavily. It's not sellers. If it was sellers selling heavily at this price level, price would have gone down more. But I can see now it is analyzing over 1 year period, there is significant transaction happening at this price level. So there is higher chance, looking at this quote history, it's called quote history, there is a likelihood that once it break out of the 9-10 range, it may go to 12-13 or maybe 14-15 level. In any case, once the risk distance is covered, which is very small based on this line chart of the price, risk is very small, we have significant profit potential. That's a relatively high reward risk ratio. We can change the period to 2 years and we can see the same, that at our price level, it is clear that big players are also accumulating. I think that is the reasonable interpretation of this high activity happening at this price range. If we go to 5 year period, it's the same pattern playing out. And for 10 year may be too high, but even in case of 10 year, I don't like to make decision based on 10 year data. Actually 1 year, 2 year is enough for superior profit way. We will be booking profit even for long-term investment. Either we'll be booking profit or we'll be stopped out with small loss within 1 year, 2 year. But it is no harm to just click few more mouse clicks and look at the data. In this case, we see across all the review periods that are possible, 1 year, 2 year, 5 year, 10 year, there is significantly more accumulation at this price level than, for example, this price level. So my conclusion is that if price goes up, we will have a profitable long-term investment as well. The last thing, again, visual analysis that I like to look at is how is it doing relative to the industry sector. We can see that the stock itself has dropped. As we saw from Q chart, it has stabilized. Whereas we see that the sector industry are actually stable. So again, it confirms our view that this may be a good long-term buy opportunity. Today, I explained how I use Zenith to look at fundamental data to take long-term investment opportunity. I had also shared one more trade on StarHub. And you see the at a glance chart. So let me ask the question, what do you think looking at this at a glance chart? Is there a opportunity long-term or swing trade long opportunity? I think nobody, superior profit traders will not take short now. It has already dropped a lot and it has stabilized also, as we can see on the right hand daily chart. But if you are thinking of taking long, either long-term or swing, will you trade now or will you wait? Please give your answer in the Q&A panel. Wait, yes, thank you. Yes, that is what I mentioned in the post. And that is also superior profit way to be aware of potential opportunity and track them. Attached is the StarHub at a glance. I posted it 4th April and I mentioned that it's an investment opportunity if memory resistance is broken. It is inside a triangle pattern bounded by resistance memory and support memory, and we would like to take a long if the memory is broken. But of course, if breaks and shoots up, we will wait for it to tail down and then tilt up again, giving us a proper go through long opportunity. So that was what I posted. I am still tracking it. If we look at the meta stock chart now, we can see that once again, respecting the memory line and waiting was a good idea. It is still inside the triangle, didn't break the memory resistance yet, and it didn't make the support yet also. So we will wait patiently to see if it goes up above the memory resistance line. And I did the same analysis using Zenith. Let's look at 1 year period. So in terms of relative performance, StarHub dropped from the peak quite a lot, the yellow line. The low is at somewhat at same level and it seems to be stabilizing. Now it is bringing the sector industry properly and we see sector industry is stable. If we look at estimates, analyst estimate, we'll again see that following analyst estimate will be a disaster. Let's look at 1 year data. The green line again is analyst projection of earnings, and you see when they started dropping the earnings projection. By that time, price has dropped hugely. Now, if we look at the actual earnings data, why I said that revenue is less important than earnings, we see that there was a huge jump in revenue, but the earnings dropped and price dropped. Finally, a company's stock price is decided by how much it is earning for its shareholders. Revenue may be very high, but if expenses are high, there is no profit, so shareholders don't earn any money. So earnings per share is more important, or earnings per share growth is more important for a stock's price increase, fundamentally speaking. Now at the right edge, again, it is stabilizing after this earnings drop. We saw that industry is supportive. So all these charts are saying that it may be a good long-term opportunity coming soon, not yet. Last chart that we looked at is quote history, StarHub. Again, for the current price range, we can see for 1 year, there is heavy accumulation at this price range. So if there is heavy accumulation at this price range, 2.5 to 3, we could potentially take a low risk long-term investment. That's how Zenith helps me decide on long-term investment opportunities. That is all that I wanted to share. Thank you again for joining this week's class. It's always a pleasure to be with you, and I look forward to seeing you. Have a great week.